Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am going to, in this episode, give you a quick status update on the C++ 20, or now at this point is it C++ 23, RPG game that I started last year. Now I've done very few updates on this publicly, but you can see here that I have been working on it. And this may be not quite what you expected to see at this point, but I'm having fun, so I'm gonna keep going down this road. So this is the main world overview. We have 5 towns here. You can see in the bottom, I've got an endurance score of 8. I have 64 units of cash on me, and I have a stamina of 28 out of 28 at the moment. In the upper right-hand corner, we see a counter that is telling us the number of microseconds in hex that have passed in each game loop iteration. Now, we can walk around the game and we can see our stamina decreasing. And you might notice that the stamina is in hex, and that is because I have not yet implemented a decimal display of numbers. And we can walk into a town, see the name of the town, see the stores that are available here, and exit the town, and properly exit on the correct side of the town. So if we want to pass this mountain range here, we have to go through the town to the left. But unfortunately, as you can see, I spent so much time walking around the town that I became so exhausted that I passed out. Passersby stole some of my cash and items, but a kind soul has dropped me off at a nearby inn. Which town am I in? I'm in Wheat Town here. I think that's the one that I last left off on. Here we go. Now let's see if we can get back here. So you can see the stamina is actually increasing. So I am slowly leveling up. All of these things need to be tweaked for sure. But if I want to get to the other side of this mountain range, I have to pass through the town. As you can see, I didn't actually go into the gym, the inn, or the trading center here because I haven't implemented those things yet. But I can pass through and I can walk between all these locations. And if I press the menu button here, then you can see that I have an about menu option available. I can select menu items, and we can see here that this has been created in C++ 20 by me using an automated conversion from GCC generated AVR code to 6502 assembly. So yes, this is running in a Commodore 64 emulator on a 6502 processor, and it is using the latest and greatest GCC 11 for AVR. And there's a lot of potential here, and I'm gonna do a little bit of walking through the code. Now, this is all very much in a state of flux. There is a lot to do here, but the basic idea is that I compile the C++ file that has been passed to me to AVR assembly. I then parse that AVR assembly, and I do a translation of that to 6502 assembly, and then I pass that through a 6502 assembler, which then gives me a Commodore 64 PRG file. Now, it probably doesn't make sense to actually walk through every single thing going on here, but if you want to, you can browse it yourself. The main file probably needs to be trimmed down a bit. It's about 1300 lines long. Once that has been compiled though, I've given an interface that looks a lot like you would expect a C++ compiler command line interface to look. I need to tweak this a little bit right now. You have to explicitly say which C++ file you want to compile, and then you can give a target. Right now, the Commodore 64 is the only target that I support, but I do plan to support other targets in the future. And then use pass an optimization level. And I've got full command line parsing here, so we can see what the defaults are. I'm currently saying pass 02 to GCC, and I am saying run optimization passes. Now, I'm going to give you just a quick idea what those optimization passes look like, and we'll look at this code a little bit here. So this is just the compiled code and the disassembly output or assembly output. So right now this game.prg is 14K. Starting to push it a little bit. On the Commodore 64, you've got 38K of available RAM and BASIC, and I'm trying to not stomp on BASIC's RAM right now or do any like remapping of the ROMs or anything like that. So 38K is what we're looking at. As the complexity of the program grows, the size of the binary is not growing quite as much as I was afraid that it would. So this is with O2. If I compile with O3, and you can see we get lots of debug tracing output, that kind of thing. And you can see the optimization passes running here. This is a debug build of my compiler. So that's 381 optimization passes. Let's just do a quick look at this. So O3 took it from 14K to 18K. And if we take it down to OS, we only get it down to 13K. Now I'm going to do a quick launch of this. And if you've got x64 installed, this is the Vice Emulator, then you can just launch it passing the PRG file that was generated for us here. So that 13K. What we need to pay attention to closely is that counter in the upper right, that is the number of microseconds that elapsed per frame. There we go. Now, if you noticed, we actually watched the map draw, and we can see that we are in approximately A10 microseconds per frame draw. Going back to this O3 build, we're keeping in mind that was A10 microseconds per frame. And this time, watch carefully when the map draws. We're not going to watch it draw this time. It's going to appear almost instantly when it does come up. There, almost instantly. And we're at 286 microseconds, again, hex per frame. But what does that work out to? Yeah, we're approximately three times faster code, and we went from like what was it, 13K binary to an 18K binary. So that's definitely something for us to keep in mind while we're playing with this. Now, if I bring up the menu here, we'll see that we have a little bit of a problem because GCC's optimizer is actually, well, it's outsmarting me and it is optimizing all of my text draw routines here into direct writes of ASCII values. Now, the Commodore 64 doesn't use ASCII, it uses PETSCII. This still works, so the compiler didn't outsmart me too much. The build that we were actually using for the initial demo was an O2 build, and this gives us a nice happy medium. It's almost as fast as the O3 build, doesn't have some of those optimization bugs that I need to fix, and is quite a bit smaller than the O3 build. So probably going to be sticking with O2 for most of these things, but completely have the flexibility to swap these out. Notice the map drew almost instantly again. It's about twice as slow. So this makes it what, 30% faster than OS, but two times slower than O3. But it doesn't really matter because it's fast enough for our purposes, and the text routines haven't been optimized away. All interesting things to play with. I find these things interesting, and again, like I said, I'm having fun here, so I'm going to keep going down this road for this project. You're probably wondering about the game code itself. I have set up the CMake project so that the game code actually compiles also for the local host machine. It is not executable on the local host machine, but there's no reason why it couldn't be. And I've kept mostly the same architecture that I was using the last time you saw me working on this game engine when it was intended for PC. We have a game loop, and I actually have a check to see if the player has asked to exit the game. I have not yet put an exit menu in, but I believe we can safely exit back to BASIC on the Commodore 64. And I'd kind of like to maintain that capability if I can, but we'll see. And so we just say get the next event, and then we process the events. And this code needs to be cleaned up. I'm still sorting out the details, but is it a event for movement? Is it event for the about box? Is it event for the almost dead box that we saw at the beginning of this. And then if the game needs to be redrawn, it has a redraw routine. I need to move that into a function. I do have a show stats routine. And it's basically just processing each of these events. If the event is a joystick input and I don't currently have a dialog box shown, then I change the state of the player. I execute any game actions that need to occur. And these game actions, I think, are pretty interesting. Again, sorting out the details here. Here we go. So for the quote brick town, if you exit off to the left, then it's going to take you to the last map, which would be the worldview map at this particular location, 30, 4. And I'm trying to build some of this stuff a little bit more intelligently. I've got this standard array that is a static const expr thing of the set of map actions that are occurring. And I tried to make this as high level as possible, actually to the point that this next event is actually, let's see, this return type is a C++ 17 standard variant. So I'm using variants, I'm using const expr, I'm using high level things. I've got type safe geometry so that I've got points and areas, and I can do intersection of rectangles and all this stuff at a really high level in C++ and C++ 20. And it all works on the Commodore 64, which might sound a little unbelievable. Let's go ahead and go back to this code. The game.avr.asm is the raw output from AVR GCC. And I mean, we can read through this if you want to, but let's just, for the sake of showing it, that we can actually see all of these calls, symbols related to standard variant and to the dispatch table for visits of variants and all of that kind of thing. It's all in here. This is all in the AVR. No problem there. And in the 6502 translation, it all ends up there as well. So we can see the variant here. And, you know, these are just symbol entries for functions. They're just really long function names is all they really are. Now, you're probably wondering why I chose AVR, and I've probably mentioned this in other videos. It's an 8-bit processor, and I've got an 8-bit processor. It has a tiny stack mode with 128 bytes of stack. I have a tiny stack mode on the Commodore 64. It's the only stack that I've got on the 6502 processor. AVR has 32 general purpose registers. 6502 only has one general purpose register, but we've got a lot of zero page, and we can use that zero page to emulate the 32 general purpose registers that the AVR has. You can walk through all this, and I've commented it so that we can see exactly how this translation occurred. So the LDD of R7, Z plus 8 gets translated into a load of the Y register of the value 8, and then an indirect access of the value in 6C is the location of Z, which is register 30. And then we're doing an 8-byte offset from there and storing the result in 55, which is where R7 has been stored. So that all works just fine. And then these optimization passes that we saw earlier, here we go, they end up in things like this, where I am able to do a super optimization of the 6502 assembly, looking for common things that have happened in my translation. Since I'm not compiling directly for the 6502, there's going to be some inefficiencies generated. So we can do things like see that a store is immediately followed by a load of the same register, and I can elide that second load. And then I can elide the dead store to this value when I know that a store to that same value is coming up later. And this is all the multi-pass thing where I'm iterating over the assembly and looking for these optimization routines. Let's take one quick look at that, and then I'll wrap this up. I've got this game.prg is this 14922 bytes, and that is with optimize equals one. I'm going to turn off that 6502 super optimizer. And that is basically a 3K savings in the binary, which is absolutely huge when we're talking about having 38K available in total to us. So it looks like it's all working. And again, I've had a lot of fun working on this project. I plan to continue to keep working on it. And hopefully we'll have some actual gameplay in the not too distant future, not just this, you know, you can die of stamina exhaustion, basically, kind of thing. The project itself is not really ready for outside contributions. You can look at the 6502 translator itself if you have any fixes or improvements there. The game itself, I probably won't accept any pull request on that at the moment because I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do with it. But the game is just in a subfolder of the 6502-CVP project. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of C++ Weekly and this little status update about the RPG, which is probably going to have C++ 23 features in it relatively soon. You know, if I put off finishing it long enough, it might end up as a RPG in C++ 26. So be sure to subscribe so you can keep getting updates about this project.